Hi everyone, welcome back. If you are still running a Tesla K80 in your home lab, you are about to get a surprise. That 12-year-old car is technically slow, but our custom Olama 3.7 build brings it back to life, supporting compute capability 3.7. While Olama only start at 5 and the VLLM at 7. I spent 12 hours porting and bug fixing, and today I am launching V1.4, ready to run the new GPT-OSS model on your K80. I will also show you how to turn that old GPU into a creative AI thinker. In the last video, we released the raw benchmark numbers tokens per second on a single prompt. Today we are doing something entirely different. I will let GPT-OSS write my script as if it were a brainstorming partner, and we will see how far we can push that dialogue, show up for both the raw performance metrics and the conversational quality. Olama 3.7 is a community fork that keeps legacy GPU alive. It restores compute capability 3.7 support, the only version after upstream drop it. By tracing the source code, there are three possible scenarios you will hit when you running a model on a K80. First one is good scenario. The model fits on a single GK210 chip. Everything will stay on the board. There will no PCIe traffic. For example, if you run a model like Llama 3.2 3B or GMA 3 4B, it will run on a single GK210 chip. It will get best performance in this card. Second one is the OK scenario. If you're running a medium-sized model, it will split between the two GK210 chips with the PLX bridge PCIe 3.0 slot. So each GPU get about 8 GB per second bandwidth, and the PCIe traffic remain affordable. So something like GMA 3 12B or today's GPT-OSS 20B. The last situation is bad scenario. For example, if you're running large model like GMA 3 27B or DeepSeek 32B, the model will spill over to host RAM. It will cost the PCIe to RAM data and will have a sharp performance drop. Even if we have two K80s, I mean two hardware, it still have to switch data from the PCIe to the PCIe slot. Maybe it will go to CPU and go back to another PCIe slot. So this is the worst scenario we have. So we should avoid this kind of situation. So in conclusion, we better make the model size can handle by a single K80. GPT-OSS has a 20 billion parameters version in Q4 precision. So we starting a conversation with a 4K token context lens. It will consume about 17.8 gigabyte of VRAM. So the model comfortably fit on a Tesla K80, and it will split to 12 layer in one GPU and 13 layer in another GPU. So this model use virtually the entire VRAM we have in the internal PCIe switch in the board, so data can shuttle between GPUs. The Ollama will schedule the odd layer in one GPU and the even layer in another GPU. So in the end, the GPU utilization stay near 50% when the interference wrong. Following, I experiment by asking the model to write a YouTube script. The first answer response 1,455 tokens arrived at a speed of 5.26 tokens per second, which is surprisingly for a model with this size. Then I inject the prompt and the answer into a second prompt. It responds a 12 section of YouTube script. So in naturally, the longer context will slow down the generation, but the throughput stay above 5 tokens per second. After that, my third request asks the model to rewrite section 1 to 4 and discard the rest of output. Despite a prompt is roughly over 3,500 tokens, the model still deliver at 5 tokens per second. It's still amazing. While I am still figuring out the best way to leverage LLM, these experiments show the simple compilation request can boost creative work and free up mental bandwidth of us. Regardless the GPU or framework you are using. What do you think? Here is today's video. Thank you for watching. Thank you.